This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 2, Adding and Subtracting Fractions. In this episode, we'll give you two fractions with different denominators that you will have to subtract from each other. Let's go in. In this problem, I've given you 3 divided by x plus 2 minus 1 over x plus 4, and you might be tempted to just subtract them right now. But the cardinal rule of fractions is that you cannot add or subtract them unless you have an LCD. You could multiply or divide them, but you can't add or subtract them. Since we have a subtraction sign in the middle, that means we have to find the least common denominator before we continue. To figure out what that is, we look to the denominators of these fractions. We have our first term, x plus 2, and our second term, x plus 4. The LCD is just going to be those two terms multiplied together. X plus 2 times x plus 4. Our goal is going to be to make both of our fractions have this denominator. So these denominators that we've written already are going to have to change. We have to change our denominators into that. So the question is, what do we have to multiply our first denominator by in order to make it look like the least common denominator? Well, we have x plus 2 already, but the LCD also has an x plus 4. So let's make a note of that. It needs x plus 4. Now we look to our second fraction and say, well, it already has x plus 4, so it needs to have that x plus 2 as well. Alright? So now that we know what each fraction needs in order to become the least common denominator, we're going to multiply both the top and the bottom of each fraction by whatever it needs. So for this first fraction, we have 3 over x plus 2 to start off with. And we said that it needed to have x plus 4 also. So we are going to multiply both the top and the bottom by that x plus 4. Make sure that you have parentheses on there as well, or else you could run into some trouble later. Now we're going to repeat the process for the other fraction. We have minus 1 over x plus 4, and we will multiply that by what it needs, the x plus 2, right here. Also, make sure that you place parentheses around them. So with that in mind, we can rewrite this entire thing as 3 times x plus 4 divided by x plus 2 times x plus 4. All we did was multiply these two fractions together right here. Then we repeat the process for the other fraction. We have 1 times x plus 2 divided by x plus 4 times x plus 2, always in parentheses. Now we'll carry this expression forward. Now that we have two fractions here that have the same denominator, now it's okay to subtract them. Now we can write these two fractions together as one fraction. We will just combine these two numerators together. So we'll get 3 times the quantity x plus 4 minus 1 times the quantity x plus 2 divided by the LCD, x plus 2 times x plus 4. Make sure that you only write this one time. You don't have to write it twice anymore, because now it's all one fraction. Now that we have it in one fraction, our next step is to distribute this 3 across this parentheses and this negative 1 across this parentheses. Well, we'll have 3 times x, and then 3 times positive 4 makes positive 12. So this one term is split up into two terms. And then we'll do the same thing for the second part of the numerator. Negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times positive 2 is negative 2. And it is still all over the least common denominator, x plus 2 times x plus 4. Now that we've pretty much got it combined, we just have to combine any like terms that we see. That is, anything that has x can be combined. So this 3x and this minus x can be combined. And any numbers that don't have x can also be combined together. So this positive 12 and this negative 2 can be combined together. Well, 3x minus x gives us, what's 3 minus 1? Just 2x. And then positive 12 and negative 2, add that together, 12 minus 2 is plus 10, and then it's still all divided by the least common denominator still. And for this problem, this is as far as you can go. We've combined the two fractions that did not have the same denominator by finding the LCD. And then once we found the LCD, we multiplied both fractions by what we needed to in order to combine them together into one fraction. And then we have some simplification steps. We just distribute what we can and then combine any like terms. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again next episode.